Dinosaurs are among the most famous creatures in the world. Everyone at some point has seen a movie or TV series where these mythical beasts appear. However, dinosaurs did not always rule the Earth. Before them, other animals also ruled the world for a long time and were just as fascinating. But what were those animals? And what happened to them? What was the Earth like before the dinosaurs? Stay with us to find out. The history of our planet is a fascinating chronicle of changes and transformations over billions of years. 4.5 billion years ago, Earth was an unrecognizable place compared to what we know today. At this time, our home was a massive ball of fire and incandescent magma. The Hadean Era, a ball of fire. The Hadean Era covers the first 600 million years of Earth's history. From its formation through the accretion process to the formation of the lithosphere and the possible appearance of primitive oceans. During this time, our planet appeared like a ball of fire with high temperatures and intense geological activity. When the Earth began to form from the accumulation of cosmic material, it experienced numerous collisions with asteroids and comets. These impacts released a massive amount of energy, sufficiently warming the planet. In addition, the decomposition of radioactive elements in its interior contributed to the heat in this early phase of its history. Visualizing what the Earth was like 4.5 billion years ago is challenging, as direct evidence for that time has been largely lost due to subsequent geological processes. However, scientists have been able to recreate this early phase through models and simulations based on the laws of physics and astronomical observations. Back then, the Earth's surface was entirely covered by an immense ocean of incandescent magma. The average temperature of the surface reached temperatures close to 2,000 degrees Celsius, which turned our planet into a burning hell. The high temperatures meant that any attempt to form solid rocks quickly fell apart in molten magma. In heaven, there was no atmosphere as we know it today. The intense volcanic activity released large amounts of gases and water vapor, forming a primitive atmosphere composed mainly of carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, water vapor, and methane. These gases produced an extreme greenhouse effect that kept the surface even hotter than it already was due to solar radiation. In addition to the gas-laden atmosphere, Earth was shrouded in a thick cloud of dust and cosmic debris that had not yet fully settled after the planet's formation. This cloud reduced the intensity of sunlight reaching the Earth's surface, creating a dark and opaque environment. Undoubtedly, no one would think that such a place could at some point become the comfortable and blue world full of living beings that we have today. But later, some events would happen that would change this. Some of these events that are the constant bombardment of meteorites would bring one of the most valuable resources to our planet, water. Today, it is thought that Earth's water, or at least most of it, came from comets that collided with Earth in its early age. In other words, this meteorite bombardment was essential for the first living beings to develop later. 2 billion years in the past. Hail, orange dot. After cooling and entering a period of calm 2.5 billion years later, the Earth experienced a momentous milestone in its history. The emergence of cyanobacteria. Primitive microorganisms capable of photosynthesis. These organisms marked a before and after in the evolution of our planet, transforming its appearance and atmosphere. Cyanobacteria, also known as blue-green algae, were some of the first life forms to perform photosynthesis, a process by which they capture solar energy and convert it into food, releasing oxygen as a byproduct. The rise of cyanobacteria had a significant impact on the visual appearance of the Earth in those ancient times. The Earth would appear as a pale orange ball from space due to the proliferation of cyanobacteria floating in the ocean waters. These blue-green algae contained photosynthetic pigments, especially chlorophyll, which absorbed red and blue light from the solar spectrum and reflected green light, giving the planet a pale orange hue when viewed from space. The massive presence of cyanobacteria in the oceans created a vast water-dyed green and brown areas. These microorganisms had a filamentous structure grouped in floating colonies, giving rise to what some scientists call green seas. From the terrestrial perspective, the oceans would have been seen as vast expanses of water with greenish tones, a unique and fascinating landscape. This activity released oxygen into the atmosphere as a byproduct. Initially, much of this oxygen was absorbed by chemical elements present on Earth, such as iron, forming oxides and other compounds. However, oxygen production by the cyanobacteria eventually exceeded the capacity of those removal processes, leading to a drastic change. The accumulation of oxygen in the atmosphere was a transcendental event, and it is estimated that it occurred in a relatively short period, in geological terms, a few hundred million years. This process is known as the Great Oxidation. This marked a milestone in Earth's evolution, as it caused a radical change in atmospheric composition. With the accumulation of oxygen in the atmosphere, a visual change occurred on the planet. Before the Great Oxidation event, the Earth had an orange or reddish hue due to the abundance of gases rich in carbon and sulfur. Thus, the Earth went from having a pale orange hue, dominated by cyanobacteria and the oceans, to a more varied hue, where oxidized minerals, red and yellow hues, became more prominent. The change in Earth's color was a visual testimony to the impact of cyanobacteria and the Great Oxygenation event on the planet's evolution. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. 650 million years in the past. Snowball. When everything seemed to be going from strength to strength 650 million years ago, Earth experienced an episode known as Global Ice Age, which led the planet to become what scientists call a snowball. During this period, extensive ice sheets and glaciers covered most of the land surfaces and oceans, creating a cold and hostile environment. The Global Ice Age occurred due to a combination of factors, although the main trigger was the position of the continents at that time. 650 million years ago, the continents were grouped into a supercontinent called Pannotia, located near the South Pole. This configuration favored ice accumulation in large quantities due to the low incidence of solar radiation in that region. In addition, it has been postulated that geological events such as massive volcanic activity and changes in atmospheric composition may have also contributed to global cooling. However, the presence of interaction of all of these factors is still the subject of research and debate among scientists. The level of glaciation was such that if any of us set out to make a map on that primitive land, we would not be able to differentiate the border between the continent and the ocean. It is thought that the temperatures reached during this period were so low that the equator was the same as today in Antarctica. But despite these harsh conditions, the simple but resilient living beings that had emerged in the past managed to adapt and survive in the waters near the underwater vents that release the Earth's internal heat. Among the most outstanding living beings of that period are the following. 1. Algae and protists. Algae and protists were some of the most common life forms in the Neoproterozoic oceans. 2. Ediacaran. One of the most enigmatic groups of organisms from this period was the Ediacaran fauna, which included multicellular organisms of strange and varied shapes. 3. Bacteria and archaea. Although life on Earth was predominantly unicellular then, bacteria and archaea played essential roles in terrestrial and aquatic ecosystems. Earth would appear as a bright white sphere from space, almost entirely covered by extensive ice sheets and glaciers. The sheen of the ice reflected sunlight, causing the planet to glow with an unusual and distinctive glow. This snowball appearance starkly contrasted our picture of Earth today with its sprawling landmasses and blue oceans. 360 million years. Devonian explosion. 300 million years later, the appearance of the Earth would change again. The Ice Age would have ended, and the organisms that managed to adapt on the seabed would contribute to triggering one of the stages with the most incredible diversity of living beings that the planet has had, the Devonian explosion. The climate during the Devonian was hot and humid, with vast tracts of low land and swampy land covered with dense forests of ferns and primitive seed plants. Extensive mangroves have developed in coastal areas alongside river estuaries, providing biodiversity-rich habitats. As plants spread and colonize land, they also began to change the atmosphere's composition, releasing oxygen and reducing carbon dioxide levels, influencing climate and the evolution of life. The Devonian seas teemed with life, with coral reefs emerging as thriving habitats for various species. Corals and sponges dominated these marine reefs and were home to marine creatures, including trilobites, brachiopods, ammonites, and primitive fish. In addition, the first terrestrial vertebrates, such as amphibians, began to venture onto the landmass, adapting to life outside the water and making an important milestone in evolution. The Devonian epoch, also known as the Age of Fishes, witnessed an explosion of biological life unprecedented in Earth's history. This explosion refers to a period of rapid evolution and diversification of various life forms, both in the oceans and on the emerged lands. In the oceans, coral reefs have become refuges for various marine species. Trilobites, a group of marine arthropods, were some of this period's most remarkable living things. These armored invertebrates ruled the seas for much of the Devonian, and their presence was vital to maintaining the ecological balance in marine ecosystems. In addition to trilobites, ammonites also stood out in the Devonian seas. These cephalopods, which resembled modern nautiluses, populated the oceans primarily and became important markers for dating sedimentary rocks. In freshwater, Devonian fishes experienced incredible diversification. Jawless fish such as agnathous or ostracoderm dominated the early Devonian stages. However, as the age progressed, jawed fish such as placoderms and primitive bony fish began to gain ground, becoming an essential part of aquatic ecosystems. The conquest of the emerged lands. One of the most significant transformations during the Devonian was the beginning of the conquest of the emerged lands by living beings. The first terrestrial vertebrates, the amphibians, arose in this period, gradually adapting to life outside the water. Evolving from ancient lobe-finned fish, these primitive amphibians were semi-aquatic creatures that could move both in water and on dry land. Adapting to life on land presented several challenges, such as developing lungs to breathe air and robust legs to walk on land surfaces. Throughout the Devonian, amphibians underwent significant anatomical and physiological changes that allowed them to colonize new areas out of water and expand their ecological niches. In the coastal and marshy areas, the first forests of seed plants began to spread. Land plants evolved to develop stronger roots and structures that allowed them to grow taller, giving rise to primitive trees. These forests provided rich and diverse habitats for various species, including insects and small vertebrates. At this point in history, the Earth was beginning to look somewhat similar to what we know, with forests, an enormous diversity of living things, and seas teeming with life. However, this would not last long. Mass extinction of the Permian-Triassic, a mystery still unresolved. The Permian extinction took place approximately 252 million years ago. This extinction was a catastrophic event that resulted in the disappearance of many species, both in the oceans and terrestrial ecosystems. Having gone from a fireball to a rusty ball, then a snowball, and finally to a planet teeming with life, suddenly everything on Earth was challenging and living things began to die. It is estimated that about 96% of all marine species and about 70% of terrestrial species were wiped out during the Permian-Triassic extinction. The magnitude and speed of this extinction make it the most devastating in Earth's history. Even more catastrophic than the Cretaceous Paleogene extinction that killed off the dinosaurs. The exact causes of this mass extinction are not yet fully understood, but it has been suggested that it may have been caused by a combination of factors, including massive volcanic activity, drastic climate changes, increased carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere, and possibly even an asteroid or comet collision. The Permian-Triassic extinction event profoundly impacted the evolution of life on Earth. It is estimated that the impact on living beings was such that biological diversity took almost 10 million years to recover. After this event, new groups of species arose and rapid radiation of life led to the development of new ecosystems and life forms in the Triassic period, laying the foundations for the Age of Dinosaurs and the diversification of life that we know today. In 2006, the large crater of a possible asteroid impact was found in Antarctica, in a region called Wilkes Land. The crater has a diameter of about 500 kilometers and is located at a depth of 1.6 kilometers under the Antarctic ice. Scientists speculate that this impact could have caused the Permian-Triassic extinction, but insufficient data exists. Would you like us to make a video about what could have caused the Permian-Triassic extinction and if this crater found in Antarctica had anything to do with it? Let us know your opinion in the comments. Throughout Earth's history, mass extinctions have been pivotal events that have radically changed life on our planet. From the Permian-Triassic extinction to the disappearance of the dinosaurs in the Cretaceous-Paleogene, these events have shaped the evolution of life. After each catastrophe, new groups of living beings arose, adapting to the changing environmental conditions. Biological diversity has strengthened, and new species have emerged. These extinctions have demonstrated life's resilience and shaped the ecosystems we know today, a testament to life's constant and fantastic evolution on our planetary home.